Random videos. When you have a sore throat and you remember all the time that you took for granted, random videos, you hit the nail on the head with this comment. This is from the sore throat video. I also have a sore throat right now. I don't know if you'll be able to tell from my voice, but it is a bit croakier than usual. And I was actually thinking this a few days ago when I was eating some food. And every time I was swallowing the food, it was hurting me. And I was thinking, oh, those were the days when I didn't have this sore throat and I could eat without pain. But it will go, and I'm looking after it, and I'm following all my own tips, and I'm pretty much over it nearly now. But thank you for your comment. It really sort of made me reflect on life. Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. I honestly do think this is one of my favorite series to film. We're gonna be looking at health questions, we're gonna be looking at fun questions. So what are we waiting for? Let's dive in. London Bus Visuals 8. Hi Abraham, I have a concern. I don't drink any water a day as I don't like it and it makes me sick. Well, that's not very good, is it? Can I have advice, please? London Bus Visuals 8. Of course you can have advice. That's what I'm here for. This is from the How to Boost Your Energy video. Thank you for your comment. Firstly, with regards to drinking water, I think it's probably one of the most common questions I get asked in clinic. I probably get asked it at least twice a day, maybe even more. And the first thing I'm gonna say to you is there is lots of guidance on this. There isn't sort of one way to do it. But the first thing that I always look at for any patient when I'm recommending them how much water to drink is, are they fit? Are they healthy? And most importantly, do they have any medical conditions? Because certain medical conditions, you need to be reducing your water intake in. Now, it's not very common, but these are the sort of things that I check as a healthcare professional. But as long as you are fit and healthy and you're an adult, in the UK, we recommend 6 to 8 glasses of water throughout the day. So this is about 1.2 liters throughout the day. However, I know in different countries, they have different guidances. So for example, in America, I know that they recommend 2 liters of water a day. And our bodies have a very good system in keeping us hydrated. And also, for example, certain factors come into play. So, what's the temperature like? What are you doing? And also, are you eating or what are you eating? Because our bodies also absorb lots of liquid from the food that we eat. And also, from all the drinks that we have, not just water, even caffeinated drinks, like coffee, for example. I know a lot of people seem to think that if you have coffee or any sort of caffeinated drink, your body doesn't absorb the water. But this isn't actually true. So if you're having coffee, if you're having tea, all of this contains water and your body will absorb the water in it too. Now, a very easy way to know if you're hydrated is the color of your urine. So if it's clear or if it's the same color as water or even slightly yellow, that's a sign of good hydration. But if it's very dark and very concentrated, that's a sign of poor hydration. So you need to be drinking more water. And I know that some people don't like the taste of water. For example, our good friend London Bus Visuals 8, who commented he or she didn't like the taste of water. So a good little tip that you can do is add a slice of lime or lemon in your water just to give it some taste. And this has been proven to help increase people's water uptake. So try it, it might work for you. Also, remember that water, it has no calories. It's completely fine for you, it's good for you, it has no sugar either, and your teeth will thank you for it. Thank you for your comment. I really hope my tips help everyone. Let's go on to the next one. Shruti R, watching this video to sleep peacefully in history class. Shruti R, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Sleep Faster video. But your comment, it made me think really. First of all, why are you wanting to sleep in history class? And how can you fall asleep in a class? I've never understood that. And secondly, you're in class. You need to be learning. You need to be getting all that information in your brain so you can use it later on in life. So please don't fall asleep in class. And I really doubt you'll be able to fall asleep in class. But what you need to do is you need to follow my tips so you're able to sleep easier at nighttime, and then you'll wake up full of energy and then you'll go to class and learn everything and get amazing grades. But thank you for your comment. Eddie Stevenson, it amazes me the number of folks given inhaler without any training in its use, only to complain this medicine is not helping. Fantastic video. Eddie, thank you for your comment. Thank you for this fantastic comment, actually. It really got my attention. And I think you really hit the nail on the head with this one. This is from the How to Use a Spacer video and How to Use an Inhaler video. And it's right. If you're not using your inhaler right, you're not getting the right amount of medicine in the right area that's meant to go. So what's it gonna mean? It's gonna mean that your asthma is gonna be less controlled. It's gonna mean you're probably gonna have more exacerbations. So you might even have to go visit hospital more often. So we need to learn to use our inhalers properly, because I think 90% of us aren't using our inhalers properly. So we're doing one or two things wrong, even though every single patient thinks that they know everything about inhalers because they've been using it for 5, 10, 20 years. But there's always room for improvement. But also, speaking of this, a lot of practices now are kind of using my videos, I know this for a fact, and they're kind of sending links via text message or SMS to patients to watch the video and learn more about it, because it's quite difficult to counsel a patient on how to use an inhaler in one go. Because if I was to sit with a patient in this room, let's say for example, and explain to them how to use their inhaler, I guarantee you they might take one or two things and remember it, but a lot of it they'll forget. And then they will start using their inhaler wrong and not getting the right amount of medicine into their lungs, which is why a video is so useful, and which is why I love YouTube so much, because I'm able to put this video on there for other people to watch and learn, and they can rewind it, play that bit again and watch it over and over again until they become an inhaler pro. But thank you for your comment, I really liked it. Once again, it looks like we've run out of time. I really enjoyed interacting with your comments this week. And if I missed your comment, I am really sorry. We get so many comments, so it's quite easy to miss a few. So if I did miss it, please leave another comment. I'll try my best to get back to you in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember that you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.